Hello friends, welcome to Pioneer of Success, an online free educational institute. So we are continuing with the WBCS series, and today I'll be telling you some important facts about WBCS examination. Basically, we'll be talking about WBCS main examination today. So as all of you know, there are many papers in WBCS main examination and they are listed here. So you have GS1, GS2, this one GS1, GS2, and this one compulsory paper, these two actually, Bengali and English. If you are from Darjeeling and some other part of West Bengal, if you want to opt for Hindi, Urdu, Nepalese and Santali, you can do it. But most of the people take Bengali, so I will call it a Bengali paper or paper 1, and English writing paper 2. Then you have paper 3 and paper 4, that is GS1 and GS2. In your GS1, you have, if you see here, you have Indian history with special reference or emphasis on national movement. And then you have geography of India with special reference to West Bengal. So what is the main fact? You need to study the geography of West Bengal properly, and you need to study the national movement elaborately. And apart from that, you need to touch all other things. But if you focus on these two, that is Indian national movement and in geography, the special reference to West Bengal, that means West Bengal geography, then you can do better in this paper. Then you have GS2. Here you have scientific and technological advancement, environment, general knowledge and current affairs. So this part is very much important, because you have current affairs and science and technology and general knowledge. So you can do better in this part also. And then you have Constitution of India and Reserve Bank of India or Indian economy. So this is very important chapter, this is very important paper. If you can do really good in this paper, then you can have at least 150 marks out of 200 marks. Okay, this paper is very much easy for science students, because you have only reasoning and mathematics, that means arithmetic. You can easily have 190 plus in this paper. Okay, so those are papers which you need to write as compulsory, and those are from 1 to 6. Those are for all groups, that is A, B, C and D. But if you are appearing for group A and group B, then along with these 6 papers, you need to write optional paper. So you have options for many. I'll show you. Optional paper means they have enlisted a wide numbers of subject, and those are optional paper: Bengali, Hindi, Sanskrit, English, Pali, Arabic. Those are all language related, subject related. You have comparative literature, agriculture and science, you have chemistry, engineering, you have civil engineering, you have electrical engineering, economics, mathematics, law, history, geography, mechanical engineering, medical science. You have a lot of subjects. You can choose a subject out of these many subjects. Suppose I prefer chemistry, because my background is chemistry, so I prefer chemistry. Okay, so now few more things, and those are whether there is negative marks or not. That is a question of all aspirants. So it is clearly mentioned here, deduction of mark, 0.8. A deduction of 10% of full marks may be made from the total marks secured by a candidate in a particular paper if he or she discloses his or her identity by writing his name, roll number or something. So you cannot do it. You cannot write your name, roll number. If you write it, then your 10% marks will be deducted. And it is clearly mentioned here about the negative mark. This point, you focus on this point. There shall be negative marking for each wrong answer to multiple choice questions. Now you have multiple choice questions, you have essay type questions. Now, for multiple choice questions, you have negative marks. You cannot write all the questions if you do not know. So, it is better not to write. If you do not know, you skip it. Whatever or how many questions you know, that this many only you answer. And the most important thing is point number 9, discretion of the commission. That means commission can do something with its discretion. Now, what are those things? The commission has discretion to fix qualifying marks in any or all the papers. What does it mean? Many people say that there is no cutoff marks for individual subject, but if commission wants, it can decide. You can see it is written clearly here. It can fix qualifying marks in any or all the papers, subjects and in aggregate. That means suppose you have GS1, GS2. Suppose commission decides GS1 cutoff is 80, GS2 cutoff is your 70. Okay. And in aggregate, say for group C and D, the cutoff is say 610. And for say group A and B, it is 800. For say, and it remains around this only, that's why I'm taking these numbers. Now, one more thing is here, if a candidate fails to secure qualifying marks in any paper subject, the marks in that paper subject will not be considered in calculating his aggregate. That means suppose the cutoff is 70 in GS2 and you get 69, then what would happen? In your aggregate, that 69 would not be counted because you have not passed in this paper. So what would happen, even if you are getting 69, marks will be deducted. So the main point is that you need to study all the subjects properly, otherwise you may not be able to clear the examination because of those facts. So you should keep in mind all those things and you always go through the authenticated sources. That is why I have taken this WBPSC notification directly, so that you can believe on my points. So whatever information will be providing would be authenticated, so you can trust us and you can have our suggestions to prepare better. We are also working hard to make this institution a place where people can come and join hands and start working together. So this would be an interacting platform. That means it's not only the teachers, students can also come, they can share our knowledge. Basically, we are also researchers. We also appear for examinations to get an idea of examination so that we can serve you better. So this is an appeal that you come forward and join us. If you want to make videos, we'll give you a platform to make videos. We'll just publicize it and all the things will be provided from our end. So I again call all of you to write us email if you have any interest in making videos, in sharing knowledge regarding anything. You write us an email and my email ID is Ricky, RICKY, Ricky 1988, Shirshendu, SHIRSENDU at gmail.com. So you drop me email, I'll be reaching to you very soon and we'll start working together. So by the time I request you to subscribe to my channel and keep logged in so that we can serve you better. And also I request to share our videos on social media so that most of the people get benefit out of it. So thank you very much for watching our video and we'll be uploading more videos, so keep in touch.